The United States spends more per capita on health care than any other country on earth. Last year, when data was available for all countries, 2011, that year, the U.S. spent more than $8,500 per person. That's more than Norway, which was first to pass universal health care. It's more than Canada and Brazil combined. It's nearly 20 times more than China. But that doesn't necessarily translate to healthier people. For a person born in 2012, for example, they'd live to an average age of just under 79 in the United States. They'd live longer in Norway or Canada, but not as long as people in Brazil or China. Joining us to talk about all of this from Philadelphia is Wendell Potter. He is the former head of communications for a leading U.S. health insurance company. Now he advocates for healthcare reform. Wendell, thanks for joining us. What's driving the costs?
Well, in the United States, we have a very unique system, which is based on profit. Most of the big entities, the insurance companies, a lot of the hospitals, even a lot of the physician groups are profit-based. They're for-profit organizations, and certainly the pharmaceutical companies are. It's all about making money, not about getting or keeping people well or keeping them from getting sick in the first place. There's not much money in preventive care. The money comes into selling pills and treating people in hospitals and doctor's offices.
Half of all the healthcare spending in the United States goes to 5% of the population. We heard one of the people that John talked to say it's atrocious, it's an embarrassment, the disparities. Is this money being spent wisely?
No, it's not being spent wisely. We waste so much money in this country. About 30% of the money that we spend on healthcare is spent on useless administrative functions, which is not known in other countries. And that's primarily because of the insurance structure we have here with numerous competing insurance companies. Doctors and hospitals have to have a large administrative staff just to deal with that. And a lot of the money is just spent in ways that reward doctors and hospitals, but are not in the best interest of patients, unfortunately.
I think the paperwork frustrates the doctors, the patients, just about everybody. Nearly one in every $5 the U.S. government spends goes to healthcare, and even so, Americans actually see the doctor less than people in other countries. So why is that?
Well, it's because a lot of people, even if they have insurance, can't go to the doctor because of the kinds of insurance policies that are now prevalent in the United States. They have high deductibles. In other words, people, even if they have insurance, have to pay a lot of money out of their own pockets before their insurance kicks in. And that's another reason why so many Americans who have insurance, who have health insurance, find out that it's not adequate for them, and they have such high medical bills that many of them have to file for bankruptcy. It's just a very broken system. The Affordable Care Act helps in many ways, but it's far from the kind of real fix that we need in this country.
You said broken. A lot of people say that this healthcare structure in this country is skewed. Companies that make medicine earn the most profit. Companies that make medical supplies, not as much. Hospitals and health insurance companies actually make the least amount of profit. So does the system itself need to be changed, and how difficult would that be?
It would be very difficult because all of those entities that you mentioned, all those industries have lobbyists. They spend enormous amounts of money lobbying Congress and making campaign contributions. They really call the shots in Washington. That's why it is so hard to get anything done. And even though the hospitals and the insurance companies, their profit margins are not as big as the drug makers, they still make billions of dollars. They're not really hurting. They just don't have the large profit margins, but they make many billions of dollars every year.
Wendell, thank you so much for joining us and providing the analysis. Appreciate it.